सभी को नमस्ते। आई मृत्युंजय शर्मा ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ कॉलेज दुनिया वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस न्यू एपिसोड ऑफ थॉटफुल लीडर्स नेम्ड एज थॉट्स ऑन एजुकेशन एन इनिशिएटिव बाय collegedunia.com। एंड एवरी टाइम वी इंटरव्यू अ लीडर वी जस्ट ट्राई टू ब्रिंग द स्टूडेंट्स मोर क्लोजर टूवर्ड्स देयर यूनिवर्सिटी टूवर्ड्स द विजन ऑफ देयर लीडर। एंड टुडे आई हैव विद मी सम स्पेशल गेस्ट डॉक्टर कुलदीप कुमार सर डीन इन अकेडमिक्स एपी गोयल शिमला यूनिवर्सिटी शिमला। How are you, sir?
I am good, and thank you, and my heartfelt greetings from Shimla University to College Duniya as well. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I will just start up with your brief introduction, sir. You are currently the Dean Academics of AP Goel Shimla University, Shimla. Dr. Kuldeep Kumar did his PhD. Faculty of Commerce and Management Studies from Himachal Pradesh University, Shimla in 2006. He did MPhil on the topic Faculty of Commerce and Management Studies from the same university, Himachal Pradesh University, Shimla in 2001. In 2000, he did MCom from Himachal Pradesh University, Shimla and BCom from the same university in 1998. You have holded many key positions in your lifespan, sir. I will just brief about some. He was the associate professor JK Business School, Sohna Road, Gurgaon from 2016 to 2017. He was the associate professor Vedanta Institute, formerly IIMT School of Management, Gurgaon from 2014 to 16. Assistant professor School of Management, Ansal Institute of Technology, Gurgaon from 2008 to 2014, and there are so many means great achievements you had in your life, Spencer. Thank you so much for giving your time, sir, today. How are you, sir?
Thank you, sir. Thank you for nice introduction. Thank you.
Sir, I will just start up with the questions, brief questions. And sir, my first question is, being the Dean Academics at AP Goel Shimla University, how do you plan and strategize the activities to increase the students' outreach?
Thank you for giving this question and taking this question for me. It is a very good question, sir, that you know that as a student outreach is becoming challenging, and specifically if you see nowadays, pandemic is across the world, we are facing a lot of challenges. Before I answer this question, I just introduced my university, because it is also very important to introduce the organizations, and then let's see that how we are going to plan and strategize for this students' outreach. Sir, we as AP Goel Shimla University established in the year 2012, and it is duly recognized by University Grant Commission. And we are totally fully authorized to offer degree under section 2F as well. And sir, this is a Himachal, so Himachal, there is a Himachal Pradesh Private Education Regulatory Commission who actually regulates the universities, their quality education, monitoring, teaching, academics, all other activities are being monitored on a regular basis by this regulatory commission. So we are very proud, we are very happy that the regulatory commission in Himachal Pradesh is always facilitating the universities across the state, all the districts in Himachal Pradesh, and whatever the lacking on the part of the working, they actually guide us, support us the way where the students' expectations cannot be affected anyway. So it means that students' expectations are centered at the university level for the academic empowerment. The second thing that in state government we are also authorized, because the university has also been established by the state government under its legislative act. So we are fully recognized by Himachal Pradesh State Government, HP Education Private Regulatory Commission, and University Grant Commission. So you see that when the universities are recognized, when you see the guidelines or the directions which are floated and which are issued by the regulating bodies, whether it is at national level or state level, then we as a university need to take care of the students. So So in the same line, sir, we at AP Goel Shimla University have planned and strategized everything. So that's why our students should not feel that there is a damage on the academic part. As you will also be happy to know that AP Goel Shimla University, consisting of the different type of diverse culture students, they come from different countries, and you see that more than 28 country students have been coming and joining our academic program since 2012, and you see that 29 states overall India. So all you see that all different diverse culture stuff is here, and you see a lot of opportunities to learn, not as a students visually, but you see as a staff member, they also feel sometimes a different opportunities to learn from the students by knowing their different culture. So as far as your question is there, that how we plan and strategize to have a proper student outreach, we have a very strong you see mentorship practice that is at our place, that once any student joins us in any program, then we allocate them individual one-to-one mentor. So that's why since he's joining the program until he is completing his degree, he is in contact, regular contact with that mentor. We are not changing any mentor. So it means the mentor, if once allocated to the students, then he will remain with the same mentor for his entire academic program. Suppose the program is of 3 years, so there will be no any change between mentor and the students. Now, through this strong mentorship program, you see, we regularly monitor the student, not only the academic progress. There are so many other difficulties, because you see the student is coming from the far countries, and then he is coming, he first of all wants to make his settle down, psychological problem, feelings problem, or the cultural problem. So we are not just contacting and giving him the instructions relating to academics. We just make them feel comfort as like a home, and then we slowly convert his feelings and emotions and his interest towards his academic endeavor. So you see, the AP Goel Shimla University, one more that is very important part of the university, which is doing its well in the IT. You know, this university is IT savvy. So whenever you see the number of webinar series in different areas going on, if you see Google and you see Shimla University, you will see an alternate day there is a webinars going on. So students are well connected through the different types of activities, academic as well as non-academic activities. So that's why students feel that not only the academic endeavor or the academic front is well taken care of, but no, any other fields which they are of more interest, we are going to connect them in that field also through organizing different types of webinars. So this is a basic thing that is we plan and we strategize. So we are going to connect with the students, keeping in view its holistic development, holistic approach of the student, where he is or she is lacking. So we are connecting accordingly. So that's why student gets full benefits, which is very important for their holistic development.
So that's great from your side. Means in the pandemic also, you have done, and the college didn't stop and just continuously worked for the students to serve them. So it's great of you. So moving forward, my next question to you is, have you introduced any new program at your institute? If yes, please give us a brief highlight of the same. And if no, means how do you are planning of the coming coming semester or the coming year?
Yes, it is you know that the new program is the life for future, and when you see that there is a need of change, certainly universities need to introduce a new program. So in that line, certainly the AP Goel Shimla University is a leading university. Whenever you see that there is a new future is coming for new generation, right now you see that Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, advanced computing programs are the need of the hour. So we are moving towards the IT virtual world, and accordingly you see a lot of opportunities for the younger generations started. So in this, the AP Coalition University has already introduced different new age programs in this session 2020 and 21. So we have introduced a new age program in forensic sciences. We have BSc forensic sciences. We have biotechnology, BSc biotechnology. And in advanced computing, if you see, we have artificial intelligence, BTech advanced computing, BTech in Internet of Things, data science. Similarly, if you see that there is a future in designing, so we have B designing, product design, space design. And if you see under management, new programs are coming, because you see that now you cannot be stabilized on the account of a fixed curriculum design. You have to change the curriculum design as per the industrial environment. So in the management, if you see that different various programs we have launched at UG level, we have tied up very good MOU with the ACCA, International Finance and Accounting, BCom. And similarly, BBA Business Analytics, you see a lot of future. There is a lot of analytics which is very important for as a student, as a manager in the any organization, that how do you analyze the market scenario, the consumer behavior, and their buying pattern or the market pattern. So a lot of analytics require there. So accordingly, we have designed our programs in BBA Analytics. The second, if you see, next program that we have designed at PG level, MBA Industry Integrated with Global Experience. You see that when student is coming, he is not just studying the courses which we have designed, but there is a need to relook into industry environment, where the students, once over with his academic endeavor program, then how he is much fit for the industry requirement. So he should be industry ready. So we are making them ready during the entire program. So one program is doing, then he is connected, tied up with any particular industry. And now you see during pandemic, when we launched this program, now we have just little bit change in this program that might be student cannot join physically. So a lot of virtual assignments are given and they're connected with the industry people. And then a lot of online interaction is going on with the online projects. And once he learns the project, he is completing that way. And he is coming with the class back and what he learns actually in a virtual environment as well. So the need of our is very important to understand from the academic viewpoint, from the student's viewpoint. And if you see both understanding level are mutually combined with, then there is a win-win situation for the students as well as the teacher. So we are connecting the student, teacher, and the third, that is the virtual and work environment, work field, world of work, which we usually say. So the three stakeholders are being combined, and accordingly we have designed all these syllabus curriculum, whether it is in engineering, whether it is in fashion design, whether it is in journalism, mass communication, or whether it is in management or hotel management. So yes, of course, we have introduced so many new age programs which I just highlighted before.
So that was great from your side. Means the programs you mentioned are the need of this decade, talking about AI, talking about big data, and the students will be listening this to you very calmly and very seriously, that the need of the hour is at Shimla University. So next question, sir, what about the extracurricular activities or programs to enhance the skills of the students or to expose them to the real world challenges we have in the university?
As I told you, I think you asked one question, that how you plan and strategize. So that's why student outreach is ensured. So I see that this is connected with that plan and strategy, because this is one part of our strategy. That it is very important, like I just mentioned you, that not the all the organization, you see that nowadays every university is looking about the holistic development of the student. So we cannot be in delay, that we are delay in the process of where the student advancement, student holistic development, or student personality development is not important. It is very important. We as AP Goel Shimla University, because you see that if student is lacking in any part, that it is not that he is just getting 10 CGPA, 9 CGPA or 9 out of 10 CGPA. You see that when any placement drive takes place, happens in the campus of or on the campus, first of all, they just ask one question, that what is your CGPA? Then one student say, my CGPA is 9.5. Oh, wonderful, it's great. But how you will be important for our organization? That's how do you see that you are important person, you are important part of our organization? Then they blank in that particular answer. So you see that here that that your question is coming into picture, that holistic development, this student skill is very important. So certainly if you see that the student is groomed, whether it is physically or communications or whatever, how do he walks or how do he speaks or what communication skills he is having with. So these are very important. So university, AP Goel Shimla University is very careful about the enhancement or development of these student skills. So whether it is his communication skills, whether it is his other non-verbal or verbal skills or any type of interview skills which are required. So for that, what we have designed, you see that AP Goel Shimla University has wonderfully designed the foundation courses, where in addition to the department specific courses, students are exposed to those courses and they learn out of those practical courses. Like for example, I am talking about the professional English, that is very important. So how do you write? What is the way format of letter or business letter? Or how do you speak that, how you are facing the interview when you are as an interviewer asking questions? So we are fully making the students ready from the start of first semester. So in our first semester, we have designed three courses. It is not only the communication skill. You see that world is facing the problem relating to environment pollution. So he must be aware of that, what kind of policies which are very important to protect the environment, the geography, planet, so environmental sciences, the professional English or the computing skill. You know that without computing skills, now it's the days are gone. Now we must be updated in the IT fields and basics at least must be clear, so that so you know at least A to G that what is all about the computing. You must be the master of your presentation skills, PPT or any basic computing skills which are very important to know as a student when once you go out of the academic endeavor completion. So you see the computing skills and professional English, communication skills are the part of our foundation courses. Now what the extracurricular activity, you know that the students are fond of various types of their, you know that one is his hobby is singing, dancing, art, theater or any type of hobby you can say. Now you see that the government of India is very keen and very serious about the skill development of the students, that whatever the skills or whatever the hobbies you are having with, you have to grow like that. So it means we need to take care of the students' interest. So there should be a flexibility. So we have open electives courses where the student wants to opt, he can opt dancing, art or yoga or any type of fashion related, architecture, planning. So any course he can choose. Now the extracurricular activities, the university is very careful. We are organizing. Now you see that in during this pandemic situations, we just last week organized our virtual fest, that is Moiza. And you see a wonderful participation of the students across the world, because you know students have gone back to their country once their online examination over in the month of July. Now they joined from there, they sent their videos and then a very good dancing and singing and how they are writing, story writing, and then they are rewarded according to that. So virtual fest, and there is a judge who are deciding that yes, this student should first, there is a need to improve in this particular skills or this hobby. Then they learn, they come to know, okay, this is, there is a gap. So how to improve that gap? So university is taking care of extracurricular activities as well, not the academic, not the communication skills, but yes, we protect their interest where they are and they are into that, like their extracurricular, which I just mentioned about. So yes, it is a it is a very good question which you asked. University is very serious and taking care of all these different type of extracurricular activities. The two example I just mentioned, in the month of March when the pandemic has come, so in the March suddenly there is closed down. So you see that we have a very good tie up with the UK based campus talk. There is an app. So you see that this is actually counseling app. They are supporting the students 24/7 if any students feeling solitude or there is a loneliness and sickness. So how he can be protected, how he can be counseled for that. So that's why he feels motivated during the lockdown as well. He's sitting in the room, hostel room, and no, there is no connectivity. There is just a network connectivity. So 24/7, the counseling has been started. 24/7. They are dialing the number and then, okay, I'm feeling this kind of problem, loneliness. Then there is a counselor available 24/7. You see, we have taken care of all the students in all the way, whether it is a mental problem, mental sickness or loneliness, or how do they feel during their lockdown. So all these things are well taken care of at AP Kolkata University even during this pandemic. And last week we have again signed a very good MOU with the Yodo, you know, that is a very online, national online counseling platform, Your Dost India. When you connect to that, they counsel the students according to their feeling, emotions, and how they feel demotivated, then they are to be motivated according to them. So they are feeling stress, that there is a solution to be stress. So everything, whether it is extracurricular activities, whether their hobbies, whether their interest, or whether there is counseling if required, the university is fully ready to take care of the students in all the way.
That's great from your side, sir. Means in just three questions, I can analyze that how much dedicated the teachers are and how much they have done in the pandemic for the students and how much they are focusing on the skin development. And I will surely say that the students who are watching and yet to join your university, they will definitely going to miss that virtual fest, sir. So it was a great thing. So next question to you is, sir, you mentioned so much things about the university, so much dedication in the different fields the university is giving. So what do you think as your role and responsibility towards the students and towards the university are specifically?
Yes, this is of course my domain, because I'm looking after as a Dean Academics at AP Goel Shimla University. So this is a very significant question from the academic viewpoint, because you know that universities are academic institutions. So on priority, they look into the academic quality and standard, maintenance of academic quality and standard. So it is a right question where I need to put my answer the way that UGC, University Grant Commission, and Ministry of HRD, even Government of India, just introduced the National Education Policy 2020. And in the Himachal Pradesh, this is the first state in India, they have approved the National Education Policy in the state of Himachal Pradesh. And in Himachal Pradesh, we as a private university, already taken the challenge, which is also the part of the National Education Policy 2020, where there is a talk about blended learning. And you see that blended learning is need of the hour. So you cannot go with us one mode of teaching. It is a time now has come that you have to adopt this blended learning, online and offline learning. So as far as the maintenance of quality, academic quality standard at AP Goel Shimla University, we are student-centric university. Why? Because I told you earlier that this university is comprising of different diverse culture students from across the African continent or all the other African countries, all the students from Afghanistan and Nepal, Bhutan. So you see that when student comes, then they come from a different culture and they see here a different culture, atmosphere. So So one, that is a challenge here, that how to deliver the academic to all these different diverse culture students. So one thing is very important here to mention, that we are student centric. We see that what actually the student difficulty level is there. Accordingly, we approach, we meet their expectations by understanding their difficulty level. So this is a very important student-centric approach we already introduced here since our inception of this university 2012 onwards. The one more thing that is very important, we are very flexible. Flexibility is the part of national education policy. So it means you see that in the online, this pandemic has come. So we have been very flexible in the taking of their examination, not offline. If student is sitting at home, even in last semester, what we have done, that we have taken their online examinations. That they feel comfortable that yes, you can take your examination online, internal examinations, quizzes, MCQ, descriptive assignments, they are submitting online. The most important part that I need to mention here, this is the first university in North India, you can see, that this is adopting the outcome-based education as far as the quality standard, academic quality standard is concerned. You see that if there is a student gap in their learning, in their understanding, and when you see that there is a need to relook, monitor their progress. So on the way we relook and we monitor their progress and we advise them that, okay, there is a need to improve. Why? Because this is outcome-based education. So what the course outcome you have designed, and at the completion, suppose that outcome has not been achieved, it means that is a failure if student coming to know that, okay, now course is completed, now I am like lacking there. No, not like. This is the software, this is the LMS which we designed, that student can see his particular progress, that where he is attaining his level. Suppose there is 100% to be attained by this, but he is not able to attain. So there is a pause, there is an option to relook and monitor their progress and to guide them accordingly. That is a wonderful tool which we have designed for our students, where they can see that where the lacking, and before the completion of their outcome, they fully attained their outcomes once they complete their course. That's very important.
That's very great from you.
One more thing is that affordability, you know, that is very important. We have a poor student, we have a rich student, we have a different kind of system. So we need to take care of them in the way what they want. So mentorship program is very strong at AP Gulshan University. So every type of student is well taken care of in the academics, with their counseling, with their parents, monitoring their progress, and then intimating their parents accordingly where your students are lacking and how that can be overcome with the support of the mentors. So mentors ensure their parents that yes, there is no need to worry on your part, because student has joined us and we are their academic mentor for the entire program. So there is no need to worry. Yes, he is lacking there, but we are taking care of. So there is a regular touch with the parents of the students. So that's why they're monitoring, and their progress is also regularly monitored and intimated to their parents. So that is also a very important part of this.
And I can say, sir, this what you have initiated is in very less university, that how we can just keep an eye on the individuals, how they can see their outcomes, they can measure their growth, their progress. This is very great from your university, sir. And I can just realize from you that how much dedication you have given from the past few years to means to achieve all your goals, to bring the Shimla University to a next level. But then also, sir, I will just talk about that. When you came to this institution, at that time, what was the vision and how did you try to achieve them?
Yes, I joined this university in 2017. You can see my profile, that before that profile, I have been working in Delhi NCR for last 10 years. So then when I joined this institute, then I have seen that since the student here is from the different fields, different cultures. So you see that when different students are coming to this university and they look that how it is well taken care of the students, So it is very important that when you are flexible, yes, when we are flexible approach. So it means when the students are being taken care of here, so when I joined this particular university, then I have seen that a lot of opportunities to learn from the diverse culture as well. But students are facing some kind of problems. If you see, that first problem is there, that the mentorship, that was a some way there was a change in the mentorship program. Suppose we have allocated mentor for this program, then next year the mentorship has been gone to other mentors. So then there is a communication and coordination gap or rapport problem is of the student with the new mentors. So what we have planned? We have planned that let the mentors be continued during the entire program of the students. So that's why there is no gap between the communication or monitoring the student's progress. The next point that I felt, because we have started this outcome-based education in 2018, last year. So it means before that there is a challenge for 1 year. So we thought that there should have been such kind of LMS where student can see that there is a resource uploaded. And when if student is sitting in Africa, any country, then they can log in and they can see that, okay, this material has been uploaded and they have access to read, to understand that particular course. Or the second thing, that course planning, that is very important part. The one more thing that was already existing in this university, but there was a need to improve in or develop the course curriculum, update the course curriculum design. Because the course curriculum designing and updation is very important. If you see that there is a frequent change in the industry and their requirement. So accordingly, the course designing and its development is very important. So we have regularly updated our course curriculum for last 2 years. And you see a lot of changes have been made and updated into the course curriculum. Now you see nowadays, the course curriculum development is totally updated to the mark of the industrial requirement. Now it is not only the management or the sciences. If you see, it is the need in the engineering as well. Even if you see the art, if you see humanities, law, everywhere there is a need of updation of the course designing. So we have designed that course accordingly. So there are three main points. The one point was that there is a single point of contact. That is very important to the student, because student is coming from across different countries, different culture. So actually the student wants that there should be a single point of contact for every type of problem, whether it is examination related, whether it is counseling related, whether it is academics related. So we had a very strong mentorship program for them. The second, that students must have the access to the material which is there in the university. So we have created this platform, that is outcome-based education platform. Now student is feeling very comfortable with the system. So if he's sitting in Africa, in Afghanistan or any country of Africa, now he has a full access, login and signing in, and then he is getting access. Okay, today, tomorrow is my lecture, and he is joining according to that time schedule lecture, and he is taking all the material on his laptop or the system. The third point, which I told you, that we have done since I joined this university, that updation of the course curriculum and new age programs. So we have introduced, updated all the course curriculum design, and we have introduced all the programs. Now, as of now, I think that we are fully ready and geared up to take this challenge in the new course age and in new technology era.
But that's great from your side. Means I can just analyze, and the students who will watching this will analyze that how technically sound the university is and how the university is prepared from the for the coming years. So that's great from your university. It was a very nice and healthy interaction with you, and the students will be gaining a lot after listening to this interview. Sir, any last message that you would like to give to the aspiring students or the students who are just looking to join your university, sir?
Yes, it is very important because you see that at the end, students are very much interested to take away something from the session. That is very important. So as your last question is there, that the student's message. So my message is very clear to all my dear students and aspirants that we at AP Goel Shimla University are totally ready as IT savvy university, and fully we are following the UGC guidelines. So my dear students, if you have seen that since March, there is everywhere there is a lockdown, and UGC issued a guideline relating to the academic calendars that now the there is some dates which have been extended for the examinations. Then according to that calendar which has been issued by the Ministry of HRD on 29th April, so on 30th of April we issued a similar academic calendar based upon the guidelines of the central government, Ministry of HRD. According to that calendar, it has been mentioned that the new academic session will be starting from September 1st. So according to that, my dear students, we as AP Goel Shimla University already started our academic session 2021 from 1st September onwards, and for 2 weeks long orientation session we organized successfully. Now this week onwards we have been fully prepared in the teaching delivery. But my dear students, you have seen just yesterday again Ministry of Education issued new revised academic calendar. As per that, if you see that now the academic session 2021 may be commenced from 1st of November 2020, and accordingly you see that there is a date has been extended for examination March next year. Previously it was January. So this is a very important information to my students and aspirants through this Duniya, your portal platform, that dear students, we have now again planned today onwards that what we have planned, that we have kept this batch as a batch one that has been already locked, and for that we have already started our teaching delivery. But as far as the new guidelines have come yesterday, we are planning that for the new admission process that is going on at AP Goel Shimla University, we are launching our fresh batch 2020 for these kind of students, and we will be starting the classes for this particular batch from 1st November 2020. So this is in the process. It means we are taking care of every type of students who are little bit confused that how to start and when to start our session. So my dear students, you don't worry. I think this is the time to take a decision. You cannot delay your admission for next year. Why? Because even Ministry of HRD, Ministry of Education, UGC, every regulating body is taking care of the students' interest, that they are protecting their interest. So I think you should not lose your 1 year. You should go to every college where the option is open and you see where your future is bright. So you take your decision as per your understanding. But yes, it is very important to take counseling and to take expert advice. You see in Kaun Banega Crorepati, there is also option that you take expert advice. So expert advice can be taken from your parents, from any academic counselor, which are very important. But it is for sure that you please don't waste your year. You have to take a decision and you have to take admission, and now it is fully protected. Now you can decide till 30th of October, and November 1st onwards the academic session will be starting. So my message is that please don't be panic. Take full instructions, take advice, and follow all the guidelines of pandemic. There is social distancing, everything. But first of all, please take care of your health. That is very important. Stay connected. That is also very important, because if you are staying connected with the virtual world, then you come to know, okay, where the bright future is there, where the opportunities are better, where new programs are better. So all these things. Now, my message is clear. At AP Gold Shimla University, you see that since March, we have been successfully conducted and completed our last semester online. You see that we were fully geared up during even our previous semester that we have completed. And after that, you see that we already started our first batch, 2021, first September onwards. And you see all these students are attending classes online, virtual. You need blended learning is now the opportunities which have given to us all the educational institutions. So my again suggestion is, you please see that where you are standing and where you can have a better program for you, and you please join your program as per the guidelines are given, issued to you. And the AP Goel Shimla University is fully ready and geared up to take this pandemic challenge. And we are fully ready, whether it is IT savvy, whether it is LMS, or whether it is student friendly, whether it is student centric, there is no need to worry about the ongoing sessions, even to the parents of the aspirants. So I think the message to be clear to the parents as well, that please don't panic. Everything is being taken care of even at AP Goel Shimla.
That's great from your side, sir. And it was a very, very healthy and nice interaction. And I must tell you that so descriptively you have told all the things that the students who will be looking forward to your college will have a very, very vast and very clear idea about all the things and about how technically sound the university has become now. And it was a very, very healthy and positive interaction. And the students will be, straight away joining your university now after just listening to you, sir. And it was a very, very, very nice interaction. Thank you so much for your valuable time,
sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
It was a nice interaction with you. Thank you, sir.